Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the summer semester meeting of the Cypress-Fairbanks Independent School District Safety and Security Committee. I'm Scott Hudson, Director of Emergency Management for the district with the Police Department. We've got a lot of material to cover today. Most of the items, or all of the items on the agenda, will be covered in closed session. We will be reviewing House Bill 3 and how it's pertinent to today's discussion. But first, I want to open up to opening remarks with Chief Mendez. Chief?
Good afternoon. Is it on? I don't think it's on.
Hello.
There. Oh, my.
Yeah, now it's on.
Ooh. Good afternoon. I appreciate everyone being here. It seems like we're meeting more and more frequently as a Safety and Security Committee, but today's meeting is pretty important. We have a lot of additions, reviews, changes to the EOP for the district, as well as the campus safety plans that need to be done and reviewed and approved by this committee, as well as covering the three-year annual audit that we're required to do by the state. So we'll cover those three topics this afternoon. It will, like Scott said, it is a lot of information. So I appreciate y'all's time being here to go over this with us. I will say that it's not a whole ball of fire. It's kind of, you know, a little bit boring, for lack of a better word, but please try to be as attentive as possible so that we can get through the information and make sure that it's where it needs to be for the district, and then we will move on. So as you enjoy your lunch, Scott will get us started.
Here you go, Scott.
Thank you, Chief. You can hand it to Grant. Thank you, Chief. All right, as in previous meetings, if you would take your phones out and scan the QR code here on the screen to make sure that you capture your attendance for today's meeting. Before I get into the agenda, I covered a little bit of it, but we'll go into more detail. I'd like to, again, welcome everyone, and if this is your first District Safety and Security Committee meeting with us, please stand up. All right, that's a good representation. Jesse, will you take the mic from Grant and introduce yourself to the group in your role?
I'm sorry. Hi, my name is Jesse Claiborne. I'm the Assistant Superintendent for Facilities and Construction.
Hello, thanks everyone for being here. Natalie Blassingame, a trustee.
Hi, I'm Nadia Stovall, and I'm new Director of Community Programs.
Got one more.
I am Lieutenant Rodriguez. I'm with the Harris County Constable's Office.
Thank you.
I'm Deputy Sines with the Harris County Precinct 4 Constable's Office.
Thank you for being here. If you were recently promoted in the district, and Jesse, you can stay seated, but if you were recently promoted in the district and have a new title and responsibilities, please stand and introduce yourself to the group. I love catching them when they're eating.
Thank you, Scott. Matt Morgan, Chief Operations Officer.
And for those that didn't understand the food language, it's Matt Morgan. He's the new Chief Operations Officer for the district. Thank you, everybody. And again, welcome to all of those been here and also our newcomers. So we appreciate you being here today. So as Chief and I alluded to, we have a very packed agenda today. We'll be doing our annual review of our EOP. And you'll see in the presentation why that's important for today. We will also, our office has created new campus response plans, and you guys will be reviewing those and hopefully adopting them for the coming school year for all of our campuses. And then finally, and probably the real meat and potatoes of why we're here today, is the three-year 2020-2023 safety and security audit cycle report. And you guys will see the important details of that report, and the board will get the full report at their August meeting. So, but it does require you you as a committee to review that material, to adopt that material, and then it goes to the board from there. in a report form. So again, take a few minutes, scan the QR code. At the end of the meeting, I'll come back to this slide so that you can capture it if you haven't done so already. But it's important to capture your attendance today. So first item of business, before we get into our closed session here in a little bit, will be approval of the previous two meetings. As you recall, for those that were here on April 27th and June 6th, we had special called meetings for our intruder detection audit. And I will entertain a motion individually for both of these approval of minutes that were distributed ahead of the meeting. So first I'll entertain a motion for the April 27th meeting. Chief, thank you very much. I have second. Lynn Blakesley, thank you. Any discussion? All those in favor, state aye. All those opposed, same sign. Hearing none, motion carries. All right. Similarly, June 6th, I'll entertain a motion for June 6th as previously distributed. Grant, thank you very much. Do I have a second? Oh, my trusty friend Lynn again has a second. Any discussion? All right, hearing none. All those in favor, state aye. All those opposed, same sign. Hearing none, motion carries. Okay, thank you. So we have already discussed what's on the agenda today. These are our discussion items as previously stated. And again, as a reminder, these items will be discussed in closed session pursuant to the Texas Education Code. However, before we get into that, and because it is public record, I wanted to kind of highlight some of the House Bill 3 legislation that was passed during this 88th legislative session. And this bill will take effect September 1st of this year. So I know it's a lot of material on this particular box here, but the most important thing is the sharing of our emergency operations plans and providing opportunity for walkthroughs with Department of Public Safety and our other law enforcement and public safety stakeholders. I will say that we already share our plans with those entities, and I believe majority of the ones that we work with on a regular basis has those plans, right, Grant? Yep. However, where we need to really focus for this requirement in the bill is the walkthroughs. I know that some public safety troopers, etc., have this past school year been directed to do those walkthroughs or campus visits, and typically we like to coordinate that through our police department, but this is going to be the real focus of meeting this requirement of the House Bill 3. What you'll see in this box is that in September, on September 25th, Texas School Safety Center is requiring the submission of what you see here on the screen, our basic plan, our severe weather annex, our hazardous materials annex, and within that hazardous materials annex, there has to be a train derailment appendix, okay? So that's the reason why we're here today to do the annual review of our EOP, is because of that deadline, and for you guys to have a look at it, make any feedback, and then allow us the opportunity to submit to Texas School Safety Center when they call for it due 30 days after their initial request. So what that means, they will make the request on September 25th for all districts across the state. On October 25th, those submissions will be due. Our office has already revised, reviewed again, and what you see in front of you today, or will see in front of you today, is the final product pending any feedback from the committee. So after our initial submission on October 25th or prior to, we have 90 days, or the Texas School Safety Center has 30 days to get back any feedback, and then we have 90 days to make any corrective actions. If we do not succeed in resubmitting that information in 90 days, TEA will be notified at the 30-day point. So they gave House Bill 3 a little bit of teeth, and there's a little bit more in there about what happens if a district is deficient in the submissions, and you'll see that at the bottom of the screen. Before we get into our closed session, I just want to highlight some of the other areas that House Bill 3 included. And it really focused on education service centers assistance. So education service center, in our case, Region 4, will help support school districts in the region by providing a positive behavioral interventions and support to a student to mitigate or prevent harmful, threatening, or violent behavior. They will also assist in our emergency operations and other safety and security procedures. There is a requirement in House Bill 3 for mental health training, transfer of school records. One of the biggest topics in our public safety arena is the armed security at the campuses. Agency monitoring and support. The governor, after Uvalde, established or created an Office of School Safety and Security. Well, House Bill 3 makes that concrete in establishing that office. And it's required to monitor the implementation and operation requirements related to school safety and security, such as EOPs and safety and security audits. That office at the state level will also, every 4 years, conduct a random detailed vulnerability assessment of each school district as determined by the agency. The assessment must assess facility access controls, emergency operations procedures, and other safety requirements. And they will collect any document or information identified and developed or produced relating to the monitoring of school district safety and security requirements under this section. They also, House Bill 3 also, under the Office of Safety and Security at the state level, they will be establishing school safety review teams at each education service center region. And these teams will be responsible for annually conducting the intruder detection audits of all of school campuses, which is what we experienced last year. The education service centers will provide support for those intruder detection audits, and we also saw that last year during the school year. Real quickly, the other items covered under House Bill 3 is notification regarding violent activity. There is that clause about sharing your emergency response maps and doing the walkthrough with your public safety stakeholders, as covered in the slide. And then school facilities, facility standards compliance, school safety meetings. This particular part of the bill doesn't apply to us. It's for counties with populations of less than 350,000. And then there was a clause in there for the school safety allotment. Any questions on House Bill 3 and how it applies to today or the district moving forward? If I can't answer it, we have subject matter experts in the room that could. Ms. Blaskin?
The state office, I know there was a state office before, so what is different or new about their jurisdiction based on House Bill 3?
Laura, you want to?
Or were we talking about Region 4?
Well, the Office of Safety and Security, John Scott's office.
Okay, no, sorry. It took me a minute to get going there. I've been, as y'all will know, we'll hear it. So what's really interesting about that is he put that together. We have not heard from them personally or dealt with them. But what I'll tell you is I've been working with Ken Colbert, which many of you know used to be the Spring ISD police chief. He has been assigned as the Region 4 Emergency Management Risk Manager for Region 4. So the good thing about that for us is we're the first region to have that, right? So what I'll tell you is he's carrying that message. My team's been meeting with him regularly, and what we've been doing is comparisons of House Bill 3, obviously Texas School Safety Center, what we already review you for as we go through the fire marshal's office, and we're finding that you guys are already there. I mean, the reality is that we're not very concerned that you're going to see a lot of differences from that aspect. Now, obviously, you've got maybe some more mandates you have to engage, but what I'll say is I think we'll be left alone by John Scott and folks because of Ken's involvement already in the process and already reaching out to the local authorities that are going to be doing the help. So, hope that helps.
Yeah, that's a...
y'all spoke so highly of you, I think I'm well aware of what y'all have done.
Has been an immediate partner for my office since taking the position with the region. He and I talk many times in a week, and we're looking forward to working with him in the future. To answer your question, Mrs. Blaskin, the office, as a result of Uvalde, the governor created the position of Chief School Safety and Security. And John Scott, former FBI? No.
Secret Service,
yes, thank you. Former Secret Service supervisor, I believe he was awarded that position as the first chief. And John has since built his team. He has an assistant chief and a deputy chief. And then they'll be expanding into the regions to help facilitate that safety and security program across the state. I think that answers your question.
Yeah. So there was an existing office, so that would come under that, or they're totally separate?
Totally separate as far as I know.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yeah. Any other questions on House Bill 3? And thank you, Lori, for that explanation. All right. So all this in a nutshell, there's even more bigger changes coming to our safety and security and emergency management program for the district this coming school year, which will involve all of you and probably potentially more meetings as we experienced last school year. So at this time, we will be going into our discussion items that is covered under Texas Education Code, and I will entertain a motion to go into closed session. Grant, that's made the motion. Do I have a second? Thank you. State your name, sir. Thank you, Anthony. And do I have any discussion? Hearing no discussion, all those in favor, please raise your right hand. All those opposed, same sign. All right, motion carries. Will you please cut the live feed? We have three considerations, and all of these topics were covered in closed session. So we'll take each of them by motion individually, and I would entertain a motion to consider adoption of the additions and revisions to the district's EOP. All right, thank you. I have a second. Wes, any discussion that can be discussed in open session? Hearing none. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. All those opposed, same sign. Seems to be unanimous. Item B, consider adoption of the campus crisis response plans. I'll entertain a motion to adopt those for this coming school year. Sarah Hardy, thank you. Have a second. Anthony Pineda, thank you. Any discussion? All right, hearing none. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. All those opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Thank you. Item C, consider adoption of the 2020-2023 District Safety and Security Audit Cycle Report as covered in closed session. I have a motion from Grant. Do I have a second? Lynn Blakesley. Any discussion? No discussion. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. All those opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Thank you. That concludes our action items for this agenda. Moving into good order of the order, next steps for the audit cycle report. Board of Trustees will receive it for their work session meeting on August 3rd. And as stated earlier, we will submit the DAR tool on behalf of the district from our office by August 15th. The due date for that is September 15th. Next steps our office will be looking at is to conduct the Integrated Preparedness Planning Workshop, or IPPW. This will develop an integrated preparedness plan. The preparedness workshop is considered the range of preparedness activities that in the preparedness cycle, which is displayed on the slide, in cooperation and guidance from senior leaders and other safety response personnel on a preparedness priorities and schedule preparedness activities for a multi-year integrated preparedness plan. All that in a nutshell means that we'll be developing a multi-year training and exercise plan for the next 1 to 3 years. And we will be engaging our public safety stakeholders routinely for that cycle or for that plan. Future meeting, as stated earlier, November 28th is our regular scheduled fall semester meeting, and we will be conducting a tabletop exercise for that meeting to test out our emergency operations plans. Any questions on good of the order or other comments? All right, hearing none. Motion to adjourn. So moved. Second. All in favor, stand up. And you're free to leave. Thank you. Thank you for attending. I know it was a long one.